morning. Hey, you pistol got this bridge, fellas. You best clear off. Shoot the fool!
Okay there. Easy, it's okay. Slow up now.
You there. Would you be interested in some friendly competition? I've come all the way north from Mexico to challenge a real American gunslinger. You him?
Me? A real gunslinger? Let's find out.
Okay, man. That's what I like to hear. Look, man, rules are simple, okay? Whoever shoots more of these bottles, wins. Just draw your gun and aim when you're ready, all right? Shoot! Mierda! How the hell did you beat me, huh? Ugh.
Better shot, I suppose.
That didn't make me happy at all. How about we raise the stakes, huh?
Come on, the girl. Easy, easy. Imagine this is here by accident.
You even know how to use that damn thing?
Is that a real question, or are you just being an idiot?
Well, I don't know. This ain't a mine we're in.
But the principle's the same, ain't it? Just think a second.
Shit! Hey, this here's a private financial matter, so why don't you keep right along?
Let's see if this safe is worth the effort. Easy now.
As long as it doesn't pick up.
Hello again.
Hello. Oh, hello. How are you, sir? Morgan, Mr. Morgan. I'm sorry, my nerves. I'm not quite the outdoor adventurer I thought. This is God's own country, and I feel I'm in purgatory.
I know the feeling.
No, I hope not.
So what you trying to take some pictures of, huh? Some more greedy coyotes?
No. Wolves.
Wolves? Now you really are trying to get yourself eaten.
Oh, I hope not. I left the meat over there. I thought I'd be safe, given the wind.
Yeah, sure. If you manage to attract the world's least intelligent wolf.
Well, I'll
stay with you a while. If anything comes, I'll protect you as needed.
You are a gentleman.
Now, you don't know me very well.
Well, to me, you're a gentleman.
Usually, I'm worse than the wolves.
You had many dealings with wolves, Mr. Morgan?
Sure.
But you've never been eaten.
Not through lack of trying on their part. Now, you don't know me very well.
Well, to me, you're a gentleman.
Usually. It sort of is.
Look at them. Magnificent creatures.
Especially when clawing at your eyeballs.
Come on. Stay still, my beauties.
Is that all of them? We might have kept the wolves from the door.
My whole futile existence flashed before my eyes.
Yeah, they can be pretty aggressive.
What a way to... Literally a dog's dinner. Still worse things happen at sea.
Do they?
Well, I imagine. Perhaps wolves do better at sea. Are they good swimmers? Well, who knows? You have saved my poor, foolish skin once again.
Don't mention it.
Well, I can't begin to repay my debt of gratitude. But no, I am eternally in your debt.
I do, Mr. Mason, I do. You take care now.
And you too, sir.
Let's go, girl. Yeah. Yep. Left to live.
You ain't long for this life. Ah.
Yep. Easy. Whoa.
Will you get out of the way?
You're doing this.
Hello, sir. I've come from Blackwater. I'm on the trail of a dangerous gang, Colm O'Driscoll. Heard you had some sort of incident.
We don't deal with bounty hunters around here, son.
I was just wondering if I could get a description.
Well, they weren't friends. They got in a fight, two men got killed. Now, one of them's an idiot, the other's some kind of dumb mick, so maybe them's your boys. You can look right enough when we hang them.
Thank you, Sheriff.
Let me out of here, you maggots! You think these bars can hold me? You hear me?
Arthur! Arthur!
Hello, old friend. Had a good time, did you?
You going to get me out of here?
I ain't decided yet.
Real funny.
Oh, I ain't joking, cowpoke. I heard so much bluster out of your mouth these last 6 months, and now I got an opportunity to watch you be silenced.
Well, you gotta do something.
Why?
I always looked up to you, Arthur.
Well, that's your first mistake. Listen, there's one little problem. There's only one of me, and there's a whole town full of people wanting to see you swing.
You got to do something, Arthur.
This wall just needs some good force. Yes. Hook that over the bars. See if you can pull them off.
What a modern disaster this is gonna be.
Just pull that lever. Come on.
Get out of here, come on. What the hell are you doing?
He wasn't O'Driscoll.
I knew you were scum the moment I laid eyes on you.
Keep shooting! Don't give up on me now!
calm yourself, woman. Like I said, I need to see some. Skinny! Get out here! Skinny!
It ain't Skinny, Micah. It's Norman.
Oh. You always was a letdown, you fat sack of crap. Excuse me a minute, Arthur. Something of mine. My guns. I showed him, and I'll show the rest of this town!
You have really lost it this time.
I gotta hand it to you.
Hand it?
He was gonna let me hang.
I'm starting to wish I had. And you owe Lenny, too. If he hadn't found us in time...
Yes, we'll all be thanked profusely, I promise.
Yeah, well, you're lucky Dutch has got your back. Someone.
I think we finally lost him.
Well, I hope so.
I'm giving you a holster. My way of saying thank you.
And thank you. There I was, having a dull day only for you. To liven it up by letting me help you shoot up half a town.
You're a funny fella, Arthur. Real funny. Why you act all sour all the time?
Yeah, well, you ain't funny at all. So why you gotta act like the court jester?
All right, listen. I'm sorry, but we're family now. Arthur, you and me. Sons of Dutch makes us brothers. Sometimes brothers make mistakes. I'm heading back to my little camp around back of Strawberry. Come see me. Maybe I can make things up to you.
So you ain't heading back to Dutch?
No, I've been a bad boy, Arthur. I ain't seeing Dutch till I can bring him a... peace offering. Bye now. Yeah.
Nice to see you again, sir.
Howdy there.
I don't even want to know where that money came from.
Thanks. Come on, girl.
Oh, Jesus. Partner, whew. I was almost a meal there.
Cisco girl. Yep.
Get lost already.
Mr. Thomas Downs, you owe me money.
Oh, no, no, I'm...
Oh, come here, you maggot.
Please, sir, I'll...
Really? Threaten me, would you?
Please, I have a family, sir, please.
I don't care about your family. Why'd it have to come to this, huh?
Believe me, sir. This is not forgiveness of my debt. This is just a stay.
You ain't such a do-gooder, are you? If you're running out on debts...
I'm not...
Now, wouldn't paying up have been a little easier? You borrowed money from my business partner, Herr Strauss. You owe him, you took the money. He wants it back, what's not to understand? Where's our money?
I don't have it.
Sell your place.
We already owe more than it's worth.
Then sell your wife, or your family, or something. We ain't your idea of charity. Is that clear?
Thomas!
What are you looking at?
Thomas!
I said, what you looking at, woman?
My husband isn't well. If we could just have more...
Like I said, we ain't nobody's idea of charity. Get us the money. So, you've met Sean?
Not really, but I've heard him.
Yeah, he ain't the retiring type.
Ah, how did you get on?
Not so good. He's almost dead. And they seem more or less destitute. You were a fool for lending them the money.
Well, people who aren't desperate don't seem so interested in my propositions.
Of course.
Arthur.
Dear Arthur, I've written this letter 100 times or more, and I cannot get it right. It's me. You know it's me from the bad handwriting. I know I said when we last spoke, and I was going off to get married, that we would not speak again. I know I said a lot of things, and I meant them, I suppose, at the time. But I'm not so proud as to not speak to people who care for me, or cared for me. I've been in Valentine for a couple of months. I had some bad luck, and, well, it's a long story and not an interesting one. But I am here for now. I saw a couple of the girls, or whatever the polite term is for them, that ran with you and your associates in town. And I heard tell of a man who sounded like you. I would love to see you again, if you could spare me a little bit of your time. I'm renting a room at Chadwick Farm, just north of Valentine. Yours, Mary Linton.